On the behalf of all soldiers, past, present, and future, we thank Staff Sergeant Ehlers for the contributions and heroic service that he made not only for the United States Army, but for this nation. And I'm sure that if Walter was here, he would tell you, not a bad legacy for a young man from the Central Flint Hills of Kansas.
He really started driving the country in 1941 when his brother and he and their buddies went together, put all their money in the same bucket, and bought a car so they could drive home to Kansas for Thanksgiving. That was the last time they would be home for Thanksgiving until after World War II, because when they got back to Fort Lewis, Pearl Harbor happened.
You know, if there was ever a day that we could honor a legend, today's the day. Walt was not just a legend, he was a giant. He was an icon, and he was a giant among the Medal of Honor recipients.
Because this man meant so much to so many by his example. Not just his example, his extraordinary example on the field of battle. And I mean, as you heard, not only the Medal of Honor, the Silver Star, Bronze Stars, three Purple Hearts. This was a warrior and one of the most decent men God ever made.
Fire, I didn't feel a thing, but suddenly I was rising higher, and I felt like I just made the biggest mistake. When I thought about my unborn child, when I thought about my wife, and the answer rang out clear from somewhere up above. No greater gift has man than to lay down his life for love. And I wonder, would I give my life? Or could I make that sacrifice? If I came down to it, could I take the bullet up? Yes, I would. There's a brother on my left and another on my right, and in his pocket just like mine, he's got a photograph, and they're waiting for him back home, and it's weighing on my mind. I'm not trying to be a hero, I don't want to die, but right now in this moment, you don't think twice. Just do- I would